Okay, this is a little video tutorial to help you get through Module 2, the lab activity, which involves the Rotating Sky Explorer simulation that you'll find, again, on this website. In order to get to this, you still have to go through your modules. You can only choose one of the... So in order to get to this link, that is, you go to whichever course you're in, you hit Modules. Okay, don't just go to your to-do list. Don't just go to your calendar. You have to go through Modules, choose Module 2. It'll give you all the different activities that you're supposed to be doing this week. The PowerPoints you're supposed to read, the discussion, the link to the reading quiz, but then also remember the Module 2 lab activity. So you have to click on that, and it'll give you not only the place to link to the student guide, which again, I encourage you to do the student guides. I'm not going to step through the student guide, at least not in this video. I'm just going to show you how this simulation works generally. I may try to make a future video that has this kind of the answers to the student guide, but for the time being, I just want you to go to this particular link that will take you to this simulation that I've already got popped up. Once you get to this point, you have to click on Rotating Sky Explorer. This is going to help you go through with the student guide. So you have to know how this thing works. And so notice that it pops up two different views. The celestial sphere view, which again, that treats the sky as being a big old globe, and I went through this in the last video. But this is going to give you values of declination and right ascension for a star. This is over here is the horizon view. Again, this one is based on the observer, someone standing on the Earth. Where on the sky does that particular person see a particular star? So before we even get into that, I wanted to point out, I'll show some labels here, these different points on the sky that are important. Now for this viewer, obviously you can look at it on any horizon. You can also look almost straight up, which is a point called the zenith. When you're looking straight up, you're looking at the zenith in the sky. Below your feet, opposite the zenith in the sky, is the nadir. Of course, that's on the other side of the Earth. You can't see it. It's below your feet. But straight down is the nadir. Straight up is your zenith. Now the first question is, where does your observer, who just happens to be at about 41 degrees north, where does that person see the north celestial pole? For northern hemisphere viewers, that's of course called Polaris. Well gosh, if I wanted to pinpoint where the north celestial pole, I'll just go ahead and put Polaris on there. Boom, there's a star. So where is it located? Well gosh, I could specify it as being, it's due north, and it's above the horizon. In fact, it's about 40.7 degrees, 41 degrees above the horizon. Well, notice, what's the latitude of my observer? Isn't that interesting? Whatever latitude you're at on the Earth, it appears to have a relationship to the location of the North Celestial Pole above your northern horizon. So it just so happens that in this case, the altitude of the North Celestial Pole for this viewer is about 40.7 degrees altitude, and the azimuth is around zero, because again, I'm looking due north, and that's where we start azimuth. Remember, azimuth is which horizon you're referring to. Okay, so that establishes the location of the North Celestial Pole for that observer. Now, let's ask the question, if I wanted to find the intersection of the celestial equator and the meridian. Now, the meridian is a big old circle that goes from the North Celestial Pole to the South Celestial Pole. So it's this gray line that goes from the North Celestial Pole to the South Celestial Pole. And notice that, yes, the meridian intersects. Essentially for a viewer, the meridian divides the sky into a half that is east of the north-south line and a line that is west of the north-south line. I'm going to give you a little inside information here. Are you familiar with the terms AM, PM? You should be. Well, it turns out that AM stands for on-time meridian. It is when the sun is in the eastern half of your sky. So during the daytime, the sun climbs in the sky in the morning, AM, and then it crosses the meridian, the north-south line from your viewpoint, and goes into PM, post-meridian. So that's what those terms stand for. So if you've learned nothing else in this course, now you know why we have AM and PM. AM means the sun is ante, or before the meridian, and PM means the sun is post-meridian. It's to the west of this north-south line. All right, so that's that piece of information. Now, if we wanted to specify this intersection, what is that intersection? Well, I'm going to move my star. I've created a star over here. Let me go ahead and move him over. Actually, I'll remove all stars. Again, you can remove stars. You can add stars by just clicking, shift-clicking, and you'll put a star right there at that intersection point. Well, what's that value? Well, notice that it's around, my intersection there is about 49 degrees above the southern horizon. Right? If I wanted to specify the altitude and azimuth of that star, I'd say, well, gosh, it's about 49 degrees above the horizon. Well, which horizon? My southern horizon. So the altitude is 49 degrees. The azimuth is about 180 degrees. 49 degrees, gosh. And what's my latitude? 41 degrees. So you notice when you add your latitude and the altitude of the celestial equator, you get a total of 90. So that's very interesting. Now, so let's put our star back on this north celestial pole. I wanted to show you something else. So again, hopefully you understand that from 41 degrees, if I want to find the north celestial pole, or Polaris, I would have to look 41 degrees above the northern horizon. Now let me change my location. Let me go farther north. Let me go toward the equator. Let me go toward the North Pole. I'll go on up into Canada. Notice what's happening. I'm going straight north, and now my observer, if he wants to find the Polaris, wants to find the North Celestial Pole, what does he have to do? He has to look farther up, doesn't he? He has to look 59.7 degrees above the horizon. What latitude is he at now? 59.7 degrees. Don't you notice that relationship? It turns out you can figure out your latitude on Earth if you know the altitude of Polaris. It always works that way. As I decrease the latitude, check out, as I go toward the equator. In fact, when I'm on the equator, what's the altitude of Polaris? Well, shucks, it's right on the horizon. Its altitude is 0 degrees, right? Isn't that neat? And I go to the North Pole. My latitude is 90 degrees. What's the altitude of Polaris? Well, shucks, it's straight above me. It's on my zenith. It is 90 degrees above my northern horizon. So it turns out that the altitude of any star, the altitude of the North Star will always give you your geographical latitude. Isn't that interesting? Okay, I'm going to actually chop this video up into a couple of different parts. This will be part one, and I'll come back and work through some of the other features of this simulation in part two.